Why disabling remote access doesn't, and what to do instead. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. Among the very first few things I did when our family first got our most recent computer was to disable remote access entirely. I no longer remember how I managed to do this, but that's just as well because I wouldn't even dream of re-enabling it. That's a comment I received from a reader relating to the pernicious tech support scam, where scammers call you, say that they've detected problems originating from your computer, and offer to fix it for you, perhaps even for free, if you just give them access to your computer. Here's the thing. Disabling remote access in Windows does not disable this kind of remote access. It does nothing to prevent remote access scams. Now, I'll review the setting in Windows and compare it to the remote access most commonly used by scammers. And of course, I'll review what you need to do to stay safe. There's a good chance it's something you're doing already. Windows Remote Desktop. As I outline in an article, What's the Difference Between Remote Desktop and Remote Assistance, Windows Home Editions don't support being accessed remotely by Remote Desktop. In other editions of Windows, like Windows 11 Pro that I'm looking at right now, we'll go ahead and just search for remote access, and you'll see that there's the remote desktop settings. And you can see that I have remote desktop turned off. So that's probably the setting that the original question referred to. Remote desktop allows you to use your computer as if you were sitting in front of it by connecting to it from another remote machine. It works most seamlessly on local area networks, so if you've got multiple machines behind a single router, it can be a really useful tool. Although, if it's not something you know you need, yeah, you can just leave it off. Either way, on or off, it's unrelated to the scams we hear about. Scammers rarely use remote desktop. Now, Windows Remote Assistance is something else. I'm going to go ahead and search for that. And you can see here we have this option to allow remote assistance invitations. That actually currently brings up the older style dialog with the older style setting. And you can see that I have remote assistance also disabled. In other words, I have this checkbox unchecked to allow remote assistance connections. And you can see that also remote desktop is in this version of Windows also visible in this same dialog. It's the same setting we played with earlier. Now, remote assistance is similar to remote desktop because it allows someone else to access and control your computer. You must initiate each remote assistance session, and you can watch and interact with whatever the other person is doing. Once again, I recommend you leave this off unless you're actually about to use the remote assistance feature specifically, and then turn it off again when you're done. Or, I suppose, leave it on. Once again, this too is a tool that is rarely used by scammers. Here's the thing. There are lots and lots of other tools out there available to access computers remotely. I happen to be partial to Google's Chrome Remote Desktop, but tools like TeamViewer, LogMeIn, GoToMeeting, Zoom, and many, many others are all valid and useful tools to access someone's computer remotely. Now, scammers try to convince you to install or otherwise use these tools. And to be extra clear, the tools themselves are not scams or malicious. Like most tools, though, they can be used for good or evil. The bad news, I suppose, is that none of these are affected by the remote desktop or remote assistance settings that I just described. They'll work regardless of how things are set up. The good news is that these tools don't start themselves. Like remote assistance, you have to take steps to let someone into your machine. And that's exactly what scammers try to get you to do. So, the solution is simple. Most tech support scams will be very insistent that you need to take action, action that will allow them access. Don't. Seriously, that's it. Don't. Be skeptical. Don't trust people you don't know, especially people who call you out of the blue. Use remote access as you see fit. It's an incredibly handy tool, but only use it with people and in situations you know and trust. You're giving them complete and total access to your computer. That's not something to give just anyone. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/82397. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.